Today is Friday, December 11th, 2020, and I'm your host, Max Gottlich. Today, I wanted to review my interpretations of what's been happening in the economy and financial markets the past two or so days. So much has been happening. So many records are being broken. For example, just right off the bat, Spain's 10-year yield is negative yielding for the first time ever in history. Like I said last week, there's $18 trillion of bonds that are negative yielding, which of course means that people that are still holding onto these negative yielding bonds are with 100% certainty to lose those dollars, to lose money. So, all right, let's just get right into the performance of financial markets today. And as you can see, the S&P 500 closed at 3663, the Dow closed at 3046, the NASDAQ closed at 12375, the Russell 2K closed at 1911, and the US dollar is continuing to consolidate at that 90 handle. Between 90 and 91. The volatility index surged to 2331 today, about 4%. It actually went all the way to 25, a little bit over 25. Starting midweek this week, we've seen a possible transition or rather trend correction in primarily the NASDAQ, right? There's been a lot of outflows from specifically the NASDAQ, the Dow, not so much. But anyways, you know, it's primarily due to the stimulus uncertainty, along with many other evolving uncertainties. Stocks in the S&P have fallen for the third day in a row now, right? So the labor force participation is shrinking, especially as COVID cases continue to escalate at extreme levels, which means jobs are becoming more scarce. For example, ExxonMobil decided to cut another 700 workers in Texas, right? They want a lot has been going around with Texas this week as well. They want to cut their global workforce by 15%, which is equivalent to 14,000 jobs. And this is just for ExxonMobil. And speaking of Texas, you could actually understand that HPE, Tesla, and Oracle, they're all relocating their headquarters in Texas. It shouldn't be much of a surprise, though, because or by any stretch, because why would any business pay a combined state and federal corporate tax rate of almost 30%? Obviously, they wouldn't, and they realize taxes will only get higher from here, especially with the Biden administration wanting massive government spending along with higher taxes. The top 1% of earners in Cali have to pay, you know, half of what they earn to the government, literally. So why would any smart businessman agree to this? Okay, so let's go to the next slide here. Let's talk a little bit about this chart. And this chart is actually from hedgeopia.com. They have some really great charts, actually, determining what hedge funds are doing, you know, what inflows and outflows come from these hedge funds and different asset classes. So, and what's interesting about this is hedge funds actually transitioned from being net short the NASDAQ mini futures for about 4 weeks straight to currently a net long position as of early this week. So obviously we just went over that there's a possible flag for a trend correction in the stock market. And yet hedge funds are building a net long position in tech. Let's see how much bigger this divergence between the downside performance of the NASDAQ is versus the increasing net long accumulation for hedge funds. So remember the difference between nominal yields and real yields, which is very simple. Real yields are the same thing as nominal, except you must subtract the nominal yields from inflation. Today, I mean, we'll get into CPI and, and PPI in the next video, but for this video's sake, I just wanted to go over the fact that Michigan's five-year preliminary, which means it's not final, inflation expectations went down to 2.3% this month. I think it went down from 2.5% the previous month. So this gap between real yields and nominal yields is getting wider and wider so long as QE remains and the dollar devalues itself, right? And so this divergence is real. It's very real. So this is all I got for you. I hope you have an amazing weekend, and please be safe. And please support my channel by subscribing and liking this video. It'll help the algorithm get my content out to more people. Okay, thank you very much.